The following is a special presentation of ABC Sports. The Big Ten, one of college basketball's most competitive leagues and a proving ground to many of its most successful coaches. Today, the Big Ten's two newest mentors square off in a tight race. Randy Ayer's Ohio State team is familiar to the spoiler role as his Buckeyes 2 weeks ago upset then 10th-ranked Louisville. They host Steve Fisher and his defending national champion Michigan team. The 5th-ranked Wolverines have been on a roller coaster ride this season, as evidenced by a loss at Indiana after leading by 20 points. But as of late, All-American Ramil Robinson has Michigan on a four-game win streak. A pivotal Big Ten matchup. Michigan versus Ohio State is next on ABC Sports College Basketball. City of Columbus is abuzz over their native son, new heavyweight champion James Buster Douglas. Yesterday, Columbus turned out in force to honor his stunning upset of Mike Tyson. And today, Columbus hopes to see another upset as a sold-out St. John Arena awaits a meeting between fifth-rated Michigan and the Ohio State Buckeyes. After yesterday's action, surprising Purdue has a half-game lead over Michigan State, a one-game edge over Michigan with Minnesota three back. Indiana and Ohio State at 6-6 are poised to move into the first division of the Big Ten. Hi, everybody. I'm Gary Bender. Michigan has won four in a row, and they seem to be gathering themselves as they get ready for the stretch run to repeat as NCAA champs. Ohio State now has won four of their last five, but they're going to need a miracle finish to get into the NCAAs. But remember one thing. Buster Douglas has proved this is a city of miracles. Working with me is Joe B. Hall. And Joe, this Michigan team's very interesting. Sean Higgins is out with a stress fracture, yet they've won four in a row. Ramil Robinson really picking up the slack. In fact, he's coming off his best game ever.
Well, Gary, how often do we see a key player get injured and then someone pick up that slack? Ramil Robinson has picked up his offense as Caleb has come in to take over the point and kind of relieve him to be featured more in the offense. 29 against Illinois, 33 against Minnesota in his last two outings, and has been named Big Ten Player of the Week. He averages 18.7 points per game.
Ohio State in the role of a spoiler. Very young team. They have no seniors, Joe, but they have one freshman, Jim Jackson, that's not played like a freshman.
Well, Gary, this game kind of features Michigan, an experienced team with fast success against Ohio State, a very inexperienced, youthful team, but one with dreams, and Jim Jackson epitomizes those dreams. He's never played like a freshman, and he has the statistics of a veteran. He leads Ohio State in scoring with 16.5 points a game and twice been named Big Ten Player of the Week.
The Buckeyes are tough at home. They're 9-2 thus far here at St. John Arena. We'll be back with the opening lineups of this game in just a moment.
DC's College Basketball, brought to you by the new generation of Oldsmobile. Step into the future now at your Oldsmobile dealer. By Magnavox, smart choices for smart people. Magnavox, smart, very smart. By Nike, who reminds you to just do it. And by the United States Postal Service, we deliver for you.
Michigan, 19-4, 9-3 in the Big Ten. Let's check now their starting lineups. A veteran club, of course, the big change. Demetrius Caleb is starting at guard. Sean Higgins moving out of the lineup due to the stress fracture to the left foot, and Griffin moving over in that spot. Here is a team that has no seniors. In fact, the captain is Carter in his junior year, but the biggest difference in this club is Baker. Mark Baker has really put the wheels on their up-tempo basketball game. Looking at the difference in experience, look at this. Michigan with four starters returning. On the other hand, Ohio State with two. Ohio State young, but vastly improved as this year has worn on. And Joe B. Hall, let's look first at the Michigan strategy.
Well, first of all, Michigan wants the defense the post while avoiding the fouls. Perry Carter had 29 points in the earlier game at Michigan. Control the tempo. Michigan wants a half-court game. Slow it down to get their big men in their offense.
On the other hand, what about the Buckeyes?
Ohio State wants to control the tempo also, Gary, but they want to press and break a full court game. Rebounding is important to Ohio State. They don't want to give up those offensive second opportunities to Michigan.
33-year-old Randy Ayers, 2 weeks ago, his team upset 10th-ranked Louisville. They'd like to beat the 5th-ranked Wolverines today. Ayers, 6 years an assistant, 3 with Eldon Miller, 3 with Gary Williams, and doing a very commendable job. His team at 12-10. Joe Sylvester, Jim Burr, and J.C. Limebach are the 3 officials in charge of the game. A sellout crowd, as this arena has been awaiting this one. They've been excited all week long. In the blue will be Michigan. There's Steve Fisher. He and Randy in their first years as head coaches. Steve, of course, so many years. The able assistant to Bill Frieder. And last year, the first rookie coach in history to take a team to the national title. Harry Carter against Loy Fott will go up at center. Joe Sylvester puts it in the air, and Michigan has the opening tap. Here is Caleb. He gives him so much quickness since he's come into the starting lineup. He had 19 points in the first meeting between these two. Griffin into Loy Fott. Fott coming off of a very weak performance Thursday against Minnesota when he got into foul trouble. Caleb will try the first shot, and he nails it.
Well, the two-time on the baseline there, trying to cover up Fott, opened it up for Caleb outside for that outside shot.
Here is Baker, has really put this team together. He has given them a transfusion. He's inside, can't get the lob, and coming away with his Loy Fott. Kicks it out to Ramil Robinson. He's so creative in the open floor, so strong, but Jamal Brown does a good job and does not let him take it on the baseline. It will be Michigan's ball.
Randy Ayers putting Brown on Robinson because of that height. Robinson has a tendency to take you into the low post and score. Brown will be a good defense in that area on Robinson.
Griffin, an excellent passer, second of the team at assists, and it goes to Terry Mills. He had 24 points against Minnesota on Thursday. Robinson with Jim Jackson jumping out on. Here's Griffin from the corner, and the rebound by Baker. You see his leaping ability. Baker, a Prop 48 casualty from a year ago, out of Dayton Dunbar High School. Brown out to Chris Jent. Jent, a good outside shooter, somewhat of a streaky shooter. He overpassed the ball there, but it's retrieved by Brown. 2-0 Michigan just underway here at St. John Arena. Here's Jamal Brown out of Arlington, Texas. 6'4" sophomore. The ball batted away, and it's going to be off of Ohio State. Brown touched it last.
Brown had a path to the basket right then, but lost his dribble.
Here's Caleb. Caleb gets it off Ramil Robinson. Robinson from the corner. Follow away. Griffin there with a defensive board. Kicks it out to Vott. Robinson will attempt another one. A three-point attempt. Doesn't get this one. And it's tipped up and in by Perry Carter.
Carter was fighting Vott for that rebound. And tried to tip it away from him and tipped it right into the basket.
Boy, there's some big bodies inside. Mills and Carter going against each other. Carter weighs 240 pounds. 4-0 now. In it comes to Carter. With Mills cutting off the baseline, looking for some help. Gets it outside. Jamal Brown is wide open and buries it. 2-point lead for the Wolverines.
Gary, look at this student body. They surround the floor here, close in. They're all standing, giving great support to the Buckeyes.
Perry Mills says it's the noisiest place they play on the road all year long. Broken up by Perry Carter. Good reach in that time. Here comes the freshman sensation, Jackson, up to Jamal Brown. Brown takes it inside, and he's got the basket, and he's fouled.
Jackson really did a good job here. He passed up the pass to Carter, which would have been a gamble. They hit Brown over there on the corner, and he found the baseline wide open for his drive.
He is coming off of a career-high 13-point game Thursday at Wisconsin. His offense really picking up, and he has scored all 4 points thus far for the Buckeyes and gives them a 1-point lead.
Here's what Ohio State likes. He's picking them up full court. Not necessarily to get the steal, but to pick up the tempo.
Caleb off to Robinson. Inside to Loy Fott. And Fott, after Jent tried to reach in on him, spun around and had the open shot in Michigan by one.
Well, you know, Jent had Fott off of the block there, had him out in the floor a little bit. I would give him that pass and not let him get the good pass to the basket.
Entry pass, very good inside to Carter. Off balance shot. Carter sometimes can be a very slow starter. He did that 2 weeks ago against Louisville and then came on strong in the second half.
He really has trouble both early and throw shots.
That's a travel on Bach, giving it back to Ohio State. This Ohio State team was 7-4. Then they lost some tough games on the road, but have won four of their last five. Steve Fisher's team, four in a row without Sean Higgins. Higgins is not at the game today. He has an inner ear disorder, so he did not make the trip from Ann Arbor. Chris Jett, nice pass to Brown. Robinson intimidates it and comes away with it. Out to Caleb. Blocked beautifully by Baker. Will try his first shot of the game, and he's fouled. What a play by Mark Baker on the breakaway.
Well, just a great move. He didn't give up. He stayed right at it.
Let's go to another member of our team now. Here is Jack Arruth.
Gary, for the last 2 weeks, Port Columbus has simply been aglow. First with the upset victory by the Ohio State Buckeyes 2 weeks ago against the Louisville Cardinals, then Mike Tyson's crushing defeat by their hometown, homegrown Buster Douglas. But the front page of the sports section yesterday heralded something entirely different. The Big Ten competition, the Illini, being investigated by the NCAA, and they are saying that there was cash and cars involved. We'll be talking to the assistant coach, Jimmy Collins, from the Illini concerning these charges during halftime.
Jack, those two free throws gives Ohio State a one-point lead, 16-20 to go in this first half. Caleb handling the ball really has taken some pressure off of Robinson. Jerry Mills, turnaround jump, and that was over Carter, who had pretty good defensive position.
Well, the main thing, Gary, puts Michigan back in the lead. That's what Steve Fisher wants, to keep this crowd a little bit subdued with the lead. Nothing will do it like being ahead.
Chris Jett ducks inside. The Sparta, New Jersey sophomore misses. Carter tries to follow, and Jamal Brown, who's off to a great start for the Buckeyes, now with 7 of the 9 points. Romeo at the other end. Boy, look at the bodies in there. Out it comes to Baker. Look at the quickness of Baker. He takes it the length of the floor, and he's fouled. Terry Mills picking up the foul. It'll be his second.
A great job right here by Baker, Jerry. As he picks his way down the floor like a wide receiver running through the defense.
Well, the crowd definitely in it. So is Ohio State, who leads it by one. Leads by one, but they could lead by three as we go back to this play early. As you can see here, Perry Carter going up with Loy. Bott tipped it in. Now, Bott was given the basket, but Carter helping out the Wolverine Cods.
Carter was tipping that ball away from Bott. He couldn't get to it.
Here's Carter trying a shot. Gets a roll. That may get him started now. He's been very tentative up to now.
Well, he's missed those two inside shots, Gary. He's just thinking about the defense inside. He had a little room right there and felt more relaxed.
Boy, and he and Mills had a collision underneath. Here's Romeo taking it inside, and the foul will go on Carter. Carter and Mills are going after each other, and two big, strong guys. There's not a lot of room inside. Carter picking up the foul. Robinson will go to the line. 6'8", 240-pound Perry Carter. And Missouri, Oklahoma, a game you'll see a week from today right here on ABC. Romeo Robinson, who is shooting 68% from the line, but no one will forget the two free throws he hit against Seton Hall and the overtime win for the national championship.
He can afford to miss a few now, Jerry.
He gets the second half of it, his first point of the game, and Ohio State by two. Here is Jackson. He's something special to watch. He's just going to get better and better, plays like a veteran, and this is his first year. Jamal Brown off to a fast start. Jackson has Bott picking him up into Carter. Carter, not a lot of room, but he made some.
He took that one right to the glass. He didn't try to shoot it over the defense as he did in those earlier two shots. He took that one right to the backboard.
He had 20 points and 13 rebounds and an upset against Louisville. And it goes to Mills, and Carter's picked up another foul. No, a push-up foul on Mills, and that's his third.
Well, here's Carter working inside. Watch him go up with this one. Right into the backboard with the basket.
A very critical foul. Mills caught pushing off. And that is his third. He has to sit down, and Eric Riley will come in. So Mills, who came off of that strong game Thursday, now is going to get some time on the bench. Be a interested to see how Perry Carter operates now with Mills on the sideline.
Well, we talked about Michigan's defense inside without fouling, Gary, being a key.
And up the floor, and we have a foul on Perry Carter. Ran over Mike Griffin on the break down the floor, so Carter now has picked up his second foul.
There's the foul right here. He was in his way, said Carter, set him down. So Carter goes to the bench.
So coming in will be Bill Robinson. Now, during this game, Joe, Randy Ayers wants to use Robinson and Carter at the same time, wants to get some size in there, but now he has to bring Robinson in with Carter picking up his second foul.
Well, it's good to have that option to bring in a big man for a big man. And in this case, he's a bigger postman.
He's a seven-footer out of Canton, Ohio. He's number 54, a sophomore.
Well, I think he'd have less trouble guarding Riley, who is a freshman, than he would guarding Mills, a senior.
Spot misses, and that's going to be off a jet. The partisan Buckeye fans thought Riley had a hand on it, but instead it was Ohio State.
Do you think they're partial down in that end zone, Gary?
I don't know where I got my hint. Do you?
There's a lot of red in there.
They're all standing, all the students standing. It's a tough place to win. Ask Denny Trump. Nice reach here out by Baker, and Baker traps it down. Boy, this guy is so quick. Off to Jackson. Jackson very unselfish. Sometimes he doesn't shoot enough. That ball batted out of bounds. It'll be the Buckeyes' ball. Substitutions now. Coming into the game will be Trigley along with Alex Davis. Here is Davis. He's their best pure shooter. And Trigley, big, strong, 6'8" junior out of Cleveland, who was a high school teammate at St. Joseph's of Eric Ryland. That's touched by Robinson, and they'll reset it. Ohio State with a 13-9 lead.
I think Davis has only had 5 points in his last two games, Gary, but he is a dangerous scorer for Ohio State.
He's the outside guy, and the zone being thrown up, and you want Davis in there while you've got the zone deployed.
You know, watch Baker's foot movement. He's not very neat when he's standing with the ball. Sometimes he has a tendency to shuffle those feet.
He got in trouble there with his pass. As an end result, Ohio State will lose it. So Riley will inbound. So two former high school teammates now going face-to-face. Lee and Riley. The trap on Griffith. He breaks it. Off it comes to Robinson. Boy, Robinson in the open floor. He is so much trouble. Here's Vaught wide open. Lee's going to have to get out there quickly. Robinson tries to get the defensive board. Eventually, Davis comes away with it. Alex Davis, freshman out of Cincinnati. Here's Trigg Lee, who's had some strong games. Too hard off the boards. And Griffin, who does a lot of things that don't show up in the box score, comes away with a rebound. Robinson trying to hit Riley. Here comes Baker.
To
trap it down, and it's going to be Ohio State's ball. The City of Miracle. Buster Douglas upsetting Tyson 2 weeks ago against Louisville, and Steve Fisher has to be concerned that these giant killers could turn the trick against his Wolverines from Michigan.
Gary, do you see the psychological advantage of a substitute coming in with a 15-9 lead compared to a sub coming off the bench feeling like he has to do something for Michigan?
Jackson with a three. The crowd is absolutely ecstatic. Romeo trying to bring the Wolverines back, and he is fouled on the baseline. Foul picked up by Alex Davis, trying to stay with Romeo Robinson. We've got an outstanding lineup coming up later. We're going to have UNLV against Arizona. Some will see LSU Vanderbilt, but right now it's an 18-9 game in favor of the Buckeyes. Clark Kellogg was considered to be the highest-rated recruit since the days of Jerry Lucas. He went on to become the Big Ten MVP in 1982, later playing pro ball with the Indiana Pacers, and currently a TV analyst. Kellogg to their biggest recruit since that time, and Jim Jackson. Ohio State out to an 18-9 lead. 11:41 left of the first half. This is Mike Talley, a freshman, 14, who's checked into the game. They really like him. And this is another freshman, Tony Tolbert. So guard changes now for Steve Fisher.
Well, and Michigan's gone with a smaller team, virtually three guards in there. And without Mills, that really weakens Michigan right now.
Push inside, Bill Robinson committing a foul. Let's go back to Jackaroo.
Gary, we've told you before how close the student body is to the floor here, and it can create some problems for visiting teams. During timeouts, Coach Steve Fisher has elected to keep his team on the court on folding stools. They say the sole reason for it is to give them some separation between them and the crowd.
Shot missing by Talley, rebound by Vaught, followed by Riley. That's the first point they've scored since Terry Mills went out with three fouls.
And that was one of Barris's keys, was to keep Michigan off that offensive board. And right then, they got three tries at it with two offensive rebounds.
Ohio State's had to battle hard for rebounds. However, in six of the last seven games, they've led their team in rebounding. Here's Romeo Robinson on the steal from Davis. I really think Robinson has intimidated Davis. Davis, the freshman, really finding out how good Robinson is.
Well, he has the quickness, but he doesn't have the experience to defend somebody like Robinson. I think Brown did a better job.
18-13. Michigan now climbing back in this one at the 10:48 mark. 13. We're going to back and watch Eric Riley, the freshman redshirt, follow here. Not very strong. They want him to get some size and some weight on, but a nice follow on that one.
Well, Bob drew both defensive men and left no one to block Riley off of the board. He had a clear shot to the basket.
Now, Mills is on the bench with three. We're thinking about this. With Sean Higgins not available to the team, it really hurts some more when Mills has to come out early.
Very definitely. Two starters out of the game for the team.
That ball thrown away. Jackson, such a good passer. He leads the team in assists as well as steals. Threw that one too far out of the reach of Baker, and you see Michigan now, after trailing by as many as 11, cutting it down and with a chance to get closer, and there's a reach-in foul. A foul going on Baker.
Referee really rushed that throw in as he put the ball on the floor and started the count. But was it foul on Baker right then?
That's his first.
And he saw the opportunity to really put the pressure on Michigan, wound up fouling.
Trigg Lee comes out. Chris Gent is back in the lineup now for the Buckeyes. This is Talley. He was Mr. Basketball in Michigan a year ago. Just getting better each game, playing a lot more now. As here is a turnaround by Vaught. Riley over the back. Robinson, though, had inside position, and he gets the carom.
Left position means everything. Robinson had it that time.
Foul this time on Tolbert, trying to stop Jackson. This reminder coming up, going to go out to an exciting city in Las Vegas, where UNLV, the running Rebels, will go against Arizona. You might remember it was UNLV that knocked Arizona out of the NCAAs last year, and then LSU losing to Kentucky. But they'll go against Vanderbilt, and Kentucky got beat badly last night by Alabama. Jackson. Figure that all out in the SEC, huh?
You can't figure these leagues out right now, Gary. You have to look and see where teams have to travel to this time of year, because that away schedule determines a lot of conference champions.
I tell you, this Michigan team's pretty good on the road. They're 7-3. Of course, Michigan 19-4 overall. They lost their first game of the year in the tip-off classic to Arizona. Here's Romeo Robinson in the paint. He's so tough. Follows his own shot. You see how strong he is. He's relentless, and he's fouled on good second effort.
Well, experience helps you more on the road than anything. Michigan, with all of these seniors, four seniors and a junior in their starting lineup, has got the kind of experience that can withstand that visitor's court intimidation.
Romeo now will go to the line. Robinson is so fierce a competitor, very strong, and with Caleb taking over the point guard spot, he's given that ability to roam the baseline, to take some of that strength inside, and he can cause you a lot of problems. 20-14, as he'll try to cut it to five, and he does. 5-point lead now for the Buckeyes. Baker, seventh straight start today. He took over the role after Alex Davis had started 15, and they felt he was getting tired. Coming off the bench is the sixth man. Carter backing in to Chris Gent. Gent, three-pointer. Boy, if he gets hot, look out. He is a streak shooter.
Carter drew the defense, left Jet open for that outside shot. Michigan doesn't like to leave the passer to help on someone inside and give up the outside shot. But that case, it was the only man to help on Carter.
Tony Tolbert with the knee brace and all hits. Tolbert started out the year so effectively last year in high school, then blew out a knee and has to wear that brace, even though he was not wearing it yesterday at practice. 23-17, the Buckeyes.
Doesn't look like that knee bothers him much, Gary. It is one of those big braces we've seen so many of this year.
Trying to get it into Carter. He can't come up with it. Romeo on the move. Robinson walks with it. He was indecisive. As an end result, he turns it over. Let's go back to Chris Gent's three-point shot.
Well, Gary, the Wolverines are wanting to give Riley, the freshman, some help inside. And it was Vaught that went back in to help him. Carter has an advantage over Riley inside with that experience, and that gave up the shot for Jim.
Jim has had some miserable days, like 1 of 10 and 2 of 4 from the field. Then he's had other games where everything went in, and that might be what's going to happen today as he's hit well from outside thus far. Nice entry pass to Robinson, and a little jump hook with Riley on him, and Riley playing some good D there.
Well, it was a nice offensive move by Robinson.
Over to Tally, the two freshmen operating along with Robinson, a three-guard offense now for Steve Fisher.
Ohio State has Brown back on Robinson. That height advantage will certainly help if he can contain him.
And the height advantage didn't help there. Jamal Brown at 6'4", who can leap. He jumped 6'10", and the high jump couldn't get up high enough there.
And he was in his face on that shot. It was just a great, great move by Ramil Robinson.
Boy, Michigan with Mills on the bench has battled back after trailing by 11. They are down by 3. Jeff this time does not put it up very well. And here comes Tony Tolbert. Rejected goaltending on Chris Jeff. This guy's a competitor. He goes after every loose ball, plays hard at both ends of the floor, but that time he was called for goaltending. 1-point lead now for the Buckeyes. They led 18-9 and now find themselves leading by 1. And a pushing foul inside against Robinson. He and Riley tangle up, and Bill Robinson walks away with his second foul.
Foul always goes against the bigger man when you're pushing. He's so much heavier than Riley that as they pushed against each other, Riley showed the force of that blow more than Robinson did.
Robinson has lost 40 pounds from last year. It's really helped his mobility.
There's the bump right there.
Bump with the lower part of his anatomy.
How about a little music with that one?
Okay, Riley to the line. Riley would like to have had some of those 40 pounds that Robinson shed. They just can't get any weight on this guy. He's eating all the time, and he's only up to 205 pounds.
No question about steroids here, are there?
I don't think so. They have him eating everything in sight, and this pencil-thin freshman just can't put any weight on. But they think eventually he could be the all-time shot blocker in Michigan.
He's got great touch, and he's got that one ingredient, size, that can develop into an outstanding player for Michigan.
Now, Michigan has come over to take the lead by 1, 24-23. What a comeback with one of their key players on the bench. Carter out to Jim. Alex Davis, good move by Davis. And it's going to be off of Michigan. Two players on the same team fighting over that one. And so the Buckeyes will reload. Davis, as you mentioned, not shooting all that well right now, but there's what you do when you don't shoot well. You follow your shot.
Well, Davis did what a shooter should do. He knew where that ball was coming off and went to it.
Tolbert forced that one. Robinson comes out with it. The Buckeyes by 1 and tipped out of bounds. Buckeyes will have the ball.
Here's Baker right here. And he's giving hand signals. See the pat to the top of the head? The noise is so great in here that he has to signal his teammates with hand signals. He can't call out his plays audibly.
In practice yesterday, Brian Dutcher, Steve Fisher's assistant, was showing him what that hand signal would be, so the team should have known what they were going to run as Ohio State throws the ball away.
I have
a feeling that Gent's trying to take over the game. He's trying to force too many things himself. He's that kind of competitor, but he has to keep himself in check in this type situation.
Here's Reveal now, bringing the ball up against Davis. 6 minutes to go in this first half. 1 point lead for Ohio State. Talley and Robinson doing a commendable job, and he's fouled by Loy Butt. So Robinson, with Carter getting two quick fouls, has come in, and he's done a good job on the defensive boards.
Well, that's what he has to do. He's not that great of an offensive player, but he is so important down at that defensive end, intimidating shots and getting rebounds. And positioning is what he has to think about, getting on the inside, not letting his man get to the board. Here's an opportunity here to rub off and look for... Well, Jeff ends up on the passing end, but they're posting Carter low.
Carter lost that one off the upright, and so it will give it back. Carter's still just a little bit tense, not into the flow of the game, and we saw that 2 weeks ago, and then all of a sudden he turned it up a couple of notches.
Ohio State's just crashing a little bit right here. They're just playing a little nervous. Don't like to see them losing that lead that they had, although they're one ahead right now.
By the way, you can see that knee guard on his arm, Carter's arm. He suffered the bruise in that game against Wisconsin Thursday night. Whether that's affecting his play, it's questionable, but it is there and quite obvious.
A lot of banging inside.
Riley showing a good post-up move inside, and the Wolverines by one.
Just a good job by Riley since Mills is out of there. And what he did that time, he just beat Carter to the ball. Caught the ball actually in the paint.
Riley was six in the game. Gent takes it inside. Difficult shot. Robinson follows. And they batted it out, but it'll be awarded two anyway. And Robinson right now is a very big story in this first half for Ohio State. Bill Robinson, a guy who didn't play much last year, but starting to get some minutes.
Well, Jeff puts up a pretty bad shot right here, but Robinson had the step to the basket to get the good tip.
He started four games when Harry Carter was out at the start of the year with a kidney bruise. Substitutions now coming into the ball game. As back into the game now will come Jim Jackson. Here is Jamal Brown trying to track down Talley. Loy Bott, no place to go. Out to Griffin. He doesn't shoot a lot, but he hits that one. It's a two-pointer.
Well, he was squared up well, and that pass came out, and he didn't have to do anything but pump the shot up. Just had a great angle.
He's a consummate role player, and away from the ball, Joe Sylvester has found that Riley was holding on, and he commits the foul. Reaching in on Robinson.
Foul number 42, Riley, his first team.
So that will be his first, and the 1-1 now, that's the 17th foul against Michigan.
Well, the referees caught kind of the tail end of a lot of shoving going on in there, but they're trying to clean it up. Keep that banging to a minimum on that inside. It's been a very physical game, and that's what the Big Ten's known for, Gary.
Here's Robinson with 2 points and three rebounds. Robinson out of McKinley High School in Canton, Ohio, which produced so many outstanding athletes. And I know Randy Ayers has said, if he keeps improving, this guy could be a factor on our basketball team, if not this year, by next year. Not the big, strong Grand Rapids, Michigan senior rips it down. 28 all the score.
With Robinson in there, allowing Carter to move to that power forward really makes Ohio State a complete team. They've got several years to put it all together with this squad.
Loy Bott, who shot over 66% from the field last year. This year, not quite that good. 59 hit that one for his fifth and sixth points. Two-point lead for the Wolverines.
You notice Baker's footwork right there, Gary. His tendency to shuffle that foot before he starts his dribble.
Not the shot he'd like to have. Tolbert at the other end. Good transition. Blocked by Robinson again. And there's Jim on the floor. Jackson comes up with it.
Well, they're not the superstars of this team, but Robinson and Gent combined for a great defensive effort right there.
Well, he has really been able to come in and plug the gap. Here's Gent from outside. Robinson keeps it alive, and he's fouled by Riley. So Robinson just taking up space. He's kind of like a space eater in there, and very effectively is Riley. the second foul.
Sometimes it takes a game like this to get a young player really started.
Let's go back and watch that block by Robinson.
Well, for him to run the court like he did right here and get down to put this block on Tolbert was really a great effort.
He was one of two at the stripe before that. Bott with a rebound. And Ramil will bring it up to tally as we have 3 minutes left in the first half. Three-point lead for Michigan, who trailed by as many as 11. Riley, quick post-up move inside. Robinson had inside position, but Griffith comes up with a rebound. And Griffith almost gets stripped of the ball. Tally from outside, and Robinson with another rebound. Baker takes it to the hole, and he's going to have a charge.
Was a good call, Gary. He really had the feed off to the corner, but he decided to take that one by himself.
Last two times down the floor, Baker's really forced the issue. Michigan by four.
There's been so much talk throughout this season about the stellar performance by freshman coach Randy Ayers. Everyone talking about how young he is, but no one's talked about the fact that he's a black coach. I had a chance to ask him about that, and he said one reason why they don't talk about his blackness is by his man that he calls John Thompson, the coach of Georgetown. He said he broke down those barriers so many years ago. Gary?
White or black, Randy Ayers is an outstanding young coach. 30-28, Michigan by two. 2:20 now left in this first half of play.
Ken and Robinson are switching on those crosses on the baseline, alternating between Riley and Bott defensively.
Ramil Robinson doesn't get the three-pointer. Here's Baker. Baker has it broken up by Robinson, and he saves it. Ohio State needs to keep an up-tempo game, Joe, but they're just a little out of control with this tempo.
I think that's experience. They have difficulty turning it off when Michigan forces them into a half-court game.
Jett trying to tie it up with a jump hook. Robinson, you saw him try to follow. It didn't go, and it's going to be broken up. That was Jett with a good defensive move. They got the ball to Baker, and he throws it away. Coming up at halftime, Jack Arute will discuss the NCAA allegations against Illinois of assistant coach Jimmy Collins. And then the Foot Locker Slam Fest, Chris Dolman of the Minnesota Vikings against Neon Deion Sanders of the Atlanta Falcons.
Gary, that's what we were talking about, that turnover right there. Gent made a great play to double back and steal that ball, kicked it off to Baker, and then he rushed the next pass when he had plenty of time.
Robinson with the steal!
What a game he's having.
Jackson's been Robinson. Very quiet in this game. Trigg Lee is checked back in. In it goes to Robinson, and that will be off of Bill.
You see that rush by the guards right there, just forcing that pass when it wasn't there. When they get in a half-court situation, they need to settle down, move that ball around, make the defense work a little bit.
Some of that inexperience showing up for Ohio State. No seniors on the entire team. 30 all the score, 49 seconds left in the half. Bott drawing a crowd, and that's a charge on Bott, who decks Jamal Brown. Very frustrated, Loy Bott picks up his second foul. He has really had a tough time. When that ball gets into him, he's got a lot of white shirts around him.
Well, he's a little frustrated there as he picked up the charge. But you know, Ohio State wants to control the tempo. They want to keep an up tempo. But against a veteran team like Michigan, that's not always easy. Michigan knows how and has had the experience to slow down the tempo. And they forced Ohio State into a lot of half-court setups here that Ohio State hasn't adjusted to.
Chris Setter comes in. for Michigan. And Tom Brandewee, a freshman, number 31, comes in for Ohio State. He's starting to play a little more for Randy Ayer's team. Jimmy Jackson, very unselfish, but thus far hasn't really put on the kind of show we've seen him put on this year. Trigg Lee on a nice pass, but the shot won't go, and Riley with a rebound. Again, Terry Mills is in foul trouble. He left at the 14:39 mark, and Riley's had to go since then. 14 seconds, 30 all. Ramil forcing the issue, but he's fouled by Jim Jackson.
Gary, offensively, I'm impressed with the way Jackson makes decisions. Decisions as to when to take the shot, not take the shot, when to pass. It just seems like it. He has unusual foresight for a freshman.
Unusual poise, unusual maturity. Very fundamentally sound. He played at McCumber High School in Toledo. Robinson with 8 points in the game, now 4 of 5 from the free throw line, and yet gives Michigan a 1-point lead. Ramil with 33 points Thursday against Minnesota, handing Minnesota their first loss at home this year. And Steve Fisher said unequivocally his finest game of his career.
Well, the game right now has got a lot of subs in it, but only 8 seconds to go in this half.
Jackson will have to hurry it up now. Tries a three-pointer with three men on him and has an air ball, and that will bring us to the close of this first half of play. And Randy Ayer's team down by one at the intermission. 31-30. Coming up at half, we're going to have the Foot Locker Slam Fest. Also, Jack Arruth visiting with assistant coach Jimmy Collins of Illinois. We'll return with more action from St. John's Arena after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Here at St. John Arena, we've got a close battle for Big Ten supremacy. Michigan leads Ohio State by 1 point here at halftime. Now, earlier today, we talked about the fact that the University of Illinois is being investigated by the NCAA in their basketball program concerning allegations made in their recruiting program. Now, some of the specifics of the allegations are as follows. It seems that they have learned that the possibility that Deion Thomas was offered $80,000 to sign with the Illini, as well as a brand new car. Additional allegations were made that other players were offered as much as $5,000 to sign, a letter of intent, and $5,000 yearly if they played for the Illini. Now, earlier today, I was able to talk with one of the assistant coaches and one of the key recruiting people for the Illini in their basketball program, assistant coach Jimmy Collins. And I asked him quite point blank if it was indeed true that he had offered Deion Thomas $80,000 and a brand new car to sign with the Illini.
Well, I have said on several occasions that that was not true. The young man has said it's not true. His mother has said it's not true. Everybody surrounding him has said that it's not true. It's an allegation that I am really surprised I still have hanging over my head.
Looking back retrospectively now, can you think, especially when you were in the Chicago area recruiting, did you do anything that you could see now and say maybe it might have been construed as an illegal inducement to a recruit?
I have never done anything in Chicago or anywhere else that somebody could misconstrue or think that I was offering him $80,000 or a car or anything of that nature.
Difficult situation for the Illini right now. The fact that the football team was placed on probation in 1988 makes you and the basketball team candidates for the so-called death penalty from the NCAA if they indeed find out that some of these allegations are true. What sort of a situation is that going to put you and your team in?
Well, it puts me in a very difficult situation because, like yesterday, we go to Michigan State and they're holding up death penalty signs and that type of thing. The thing that makes it difficult is that we know it's not true, yet the allegations are still there.
What about you? If you go out and you have to recruit next year and you're put back out on the road, what will you say to parents when you sit down and chat with them and they bring up this entire issue?
Well, if I'm able to go out and recruit next year and sit down and chat with parents, they will know that it wasn't true.
Well, Jim, good luck to you, and we hope that you have a fine remainder of the season. Hope things turn out well for Illini and for you personally.
Thanks, Jack. I appreciate that.
Well, Well, we should know very shortly what the final outcome will be of this entire situation. But the unfortunate side to it, in fact, the tragic side, is the fact that morally it's wrong. Ethically, what's transpired has been wrong. Not to say, nothing to say with the fact that legally, according to the NCAA, what's happened is wrong. A sad state of affairs for college basketball, and specifically a tragic turn of events for any scholar athlete.
ABC's College Basketball Halftime Report has been brought to you by LA Gear, unstoppable in performance fashion footwear. And coming up next, the Foot Locker Slam Fest, where Chris Dolman of the Vikings takes on Neon Deion Sanders of the Falcons when we return.
Ohio State by a scant 1 point. Now, we've been watching all throughout this basketball season the Foot Locker Slam Fest, and we're down to some of the semifinals as we watch Neon Deion Sanders go with Chris Dolman. Let's check in with Roger Twybill.
This man hunts quarterbacks for a living. And this season, he registered more sacks than anyone in the National Football League. Time performers starred in baseball and football. And today, these two stars will add slam dunking to their resumes. Coming up, the quarterfinal of the Foot Locker Slam Fest. The original field of 16 has been cut in half, and these eight remain in the hunt for the $50,000 top prize. Along with Dick Vitale, I'm Roger Twybill, and we're ready for today's matchup. And wow, Chris Dolman against primetime Deion Sanders.
Roger's strength against style. Here comes a guy that's got tremendous strength, was an outstanding defensive end at the University of Pittsburgh. Now he's trying to break the bank out in Minnesota. Mike Lynn, give up some cash, baby. This guy deserves it.
That's his first attempt, and he goes behind the back and over the head.
Just a traditional, fundamental reverse dunk. Nothing creative and innovative, just sheer strength and power. He'll get mad at me for saying there's nothing creative.
Hey, Dick, when you're big and you weigh 260, as he scores an 8-1, you can get up, but you come down quicker than those little guys.
I like this guy. I'll tell you one thing. You talk about flashy and showmanship. From the moment he arrives, everybody's jumping with joy. And there he is. Double clutch, left-hander.
And he can do it with his cap on. And a lot of hang time on the rim as he scores an 8-5. So the lower score from the first round has the choice of who goes first in the second round. Dolman lets Deion go first, and he slams it home.
I love that kind of dunk. We threw it up on a glass. Look at that smile. What a combination. Jerry Glanville and Deion Sanders. Atlanta, the journalists are going to love it. There he is, flipping it up on a glass. He catches it, rises, the high riser. He finalizes, and then he's going to try to egg on the crowd to get the judges to give him a few more points.
He already plays two pro sports. Dick, can he go for a third?
I'll tell you one thing. He can do almost anything he wants. He's that talented.
And
look at a big
score.
A 9.0.
All right, so now Dolman's got to get a 9-1 to beat him.
Not creative enough, not stylish enough. It's just a traditional power jam.
Remember, it's not the total of the two dunks, but the individual dunk that scores the highest, and Sanders with a 9.0 beats Dolman at 8.6. So Deion Sanders advances on in this Foot Locker Slam Fest to the semifinals. So it was the finesse of Deion Sanders over the power of Chris Dolman. What about that one, Dick?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Mr. Sanders is really showtime.
He's your kind of guy, isn't he?
He is. He's really fun to watch. I think he stole my line at PTP here, but yeah. He really is one, Roger.
Later today, Olympic silver medalist Mike Powell versus Gold Glove outfielder Devon White.
We'll return with more action from St. John Arena after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Michigan by one, and Joe B., let's look now at the strategy first of Michigan, see what's happened at the halfway point.
Well, Michigan, you know, they wanted to defense a low post without fouling, and what'd they do? They got Males in foul trouble. He only played, I think it was 5 minutes in that first half, so that's a no. Control tempo, I'd give them a yes. Ohio State really hasn't gotten the running game they would like to have. Ohio State, on the other hand, no on control of the tempo. It's been more of a half-court game. Rebounding edge, I'd call it even. Even though Michigan is out rebound them 18 to 15, that's not significant. And it indicates what we have here, a very close game.
So it's going to be Baker Jackson along with Carter and Jamal Brown and Chris Gent. That's the starters, the same five that opened the game for the Buckeyes. Here's Carter wheeling inside, gets it to Gent, who's one of six from the field in the first half. But he gets that one, and the Buckeyes on top by one.
He had enough top English on that one. It looked like it was going to miss, but it just crawled over the rim.
Here's Ramil Robinson, who's only 2 of 8 in the first half of the field. And look at the hustle by Gent. He was very careless, but give Gent a lot of credit for it. Great effort, and Carter converts it at the other end.
Well, Jen has done this all day, just come through with a great effort. And there he goes back with that enthusiasm, and he overplays right there with his hustle. But look at this right here. Robinson should never let a guy come from behind deflect that ball. But what an effort by Jen.
And then he picks up a blocking foul down on the foul line. Let's go to Jackaroo.
Gary, checking with Coach Randy Ayers as to what he told his team at halftime, it sounded almost like a repeat performance of the halftime talk at Louisville. Defensively, he said, we need more rebounds. He said, we've got to keep the University of Michigan further from the outside. And offensively, he said, we've got to go to the basket more. Almost a carbon copy of what he said against the Louisville Cardinals.
Here's Mills, who didn't play but 5 minutes of the first half due to foul trouble, and he is able to hit his first basket of the second half, and he has 4 for the game. 1-point lead for the Buckeyes.
Mills shot that out the two-time. Really a great offensive move by Mills.
Ohio State doesn't want to get a lot of half-court offense. Their inexperience really shows at times. And Jamal Brown, who was 3 of 4 in the first half and who started the Buckeyes off so effectively, was 7 points early, now has 9 for the game. Here's Robinson, 3-point attempt. Well, when you are a good shooter, you know it's going to eventually come back and you're going to start hitting some of those.
No one took him. Carter was the only man. He didn't want to leave the basket to come out. But a guard didn't get back there and stop the ball as Robinson, that wide open shot.
And he tied it up at 36. Carter wheeling in, and Carter playing like he did in the second half against Louisville. Starts out with 2 quick baskets here in the second half. 38-36, the Buckeyes. Caleb only played 9 minutes in the first half, as they went to 2 freshmen, Talley and Tolbert, in the backcourt a lot of that first half. Robinson into Mills. Nice drop step move by Mills. And this guy looks like he's upset that he was in foul trouble and didn't play much in that first half.
Well, they missed Mills in that first half, but he just made a good move then as he hung the defense with that pivot move and stepped back to the basket.
38 all.
There was no help in there that time on Mills. And I know Randy Ayers has talked to him about bringing help from that weak side.
Chris Gent tries to pass to Jackson. And coming up with it is Jamal Brown, but he's called for charging.
Watch Carter work for post position right here against Vaughn. Really makes a good move, but Vaughn accomplishes something right there. He got him a step off the block, but then he let him turn and go to the baseline. You got to keep that man off the baseline.
Jamal Brown committed his first foul. Caleb intimidated by Carter, and a missed shot. Out it comes to Baker. A hurry at the other end. Baker, nice pass to Carter, and he missed the shot. Down at the other end, Robinson, and he is fouled. And you talk about length of the 4 plays.
Carter didn't know he missed that shot, Jerry. He came back down the floor thinking that he had made that shot.
His second, team third.
Here's the kickoff right here, and Carter goes in, and watch him. He doesn't keep his eye on that ball. It rolled around the rim.
Ramil Robinson at the other end then being fouled, and now gives Michigan a 1-point lead, 39-38. He has 13 points. He's 5 of 7 from the free throw line.
Gary, you counting these misses by Carter inside? This is significant in this game. I know there's three almost what you call layups that he's missed.
And yet he got two quick baskets to start the second half, indicating he's going to have a good second half.
He means so much to this club, and those shots have got to fall for him.
Well, this guy's got to shoot more. He took only three shots in the first half, missed that one. Carter tried to keep it alive, and eventually Mills comes out and Baker with the steal. Baker creating, and he's fouled by Mike Griffin.
If he'd had the composure right then to just flick that ball to the basket, he would have got the two shots, Gary. But he, after the foul, he passes off. Watch right here. Right here, if he goes ahead and shoots it, he gets the two shots. Maybe he would have got the basket.
I think his confidence is lacking in his shooting game. He was 0 for 9 in the game against Wisconsin Thursday, even though he'd been shooting well prior to that time. Brown's been shooting well today. And with a nice follow tip, he has been a big surprise today, as now Brown in the game has gone to 11 points. 40 all.
That's what a 6'4 guard can do for you.
Mills, who's kind of taken over offensively in the second half. But Carter in position on Riley. Good job on the defensive board by Carter. Brown again for three. And Caleb is going to be fouled by Baker.
Randy Ayers calling for a foul on Brown as he was knocked to the floor after that shot right in front of Randy Ayers.
Michigan, such a good shooting team last year. They led the entire nation. They're down this year. And today, look what they're shooting.
Well, they've fallen off even since the first half.
Emil Robinson, who hit a three a moment ago, and he is fouled by Chris Jeff.
Jeff showing that that compulsive competitiveness, was anxious to leave his feet and get that block on Ramil Robinson. But he did have the block, but he also got the foul.
That foul a while ago, by the way, on Baker was his third. And now Jett has picked up his third foul. Robinson, who's hit the big ones when they needed him, down the stretch last year in the NCAAs, to break the tie at the 15-58 mark. We're going to take a break. Michigan, fifth ranked, with a one-point lead. Steve Fisher's team, they know they're in a battle. Ohio State by one.
And here's a big score, Gary. Missouri 92-90 over Oklahoma. A big win for Norm Stewart.
That was at home, and now Norm Stewart, Storm and Norman, will have to take his team to Norman, Oklahoma. And that game will be broadcast a week from today here on ABC. So Missouri right now, obviously, the inside track to the Big 8 Championship. 41-40, Michigan with the lead.
Michigan gone to a zone right here, 1-2-2.
This is where some of the inexperience shows up at Ohio State, attacking a defense from a half-court offense, and Carter puts one up, Mills with the rebound. That's not his shot.
Well, we want him on the board rebounding, Gary, not shooting it from outside. Let Jackson put it up outside. Randy Ayers would want Carter in under the basket.
Jim Jackson has not been a factor in this game thus far as he reaches in on Ramil Robinson. Griffith from the corner. Jet tips it out to Jackson. Pass broken up nicely. Intended for Baker. They go to the other end. Mills to Vaught. And Vaught misses it. Great effort by Jackson. He comes up with it.
And it was Jett against two men that stopped that basket.
And Brown is fouled. A little out of control right now as Griffith commits the foul.
This is what Randy Ayers likes about Jett. Chris Jett gives you that great effort, as you saw right then, as he came back defensively and stopped two Wolverines from scoring.
Chris Jett, who 2 weeks ago got that hairstyle done, and it hasn't grown much. I think he's starting to worry. As substitution now coming in, Talley will replace Ramil Robinson. Robinson played 17 minutes in the first half of play. He played 40 minutes in the two previous games. Here's Carter. That's just not his shot, facing a basket like that. They don't want him taking it. And here's Jamal Brown with the steal. And Brown out of control, but it's going to be a blocking foul. He got away with that one.
That's Mills' fourth.
Yeah, that's his fourth. And Brown has got to be a fortunate young man because he was totally out of control on that play.
Mills firmly believes that he had position. We'll take a look. I give it a charge, Gary.
I do, too. I agree. So Mills Now with his fourth has the lead. He picked up his third at the 14:39 mark of the first half. And now exactly the same time in the second half he leads at 14:39.
Well, here it is again. And I say Mills was playing it. A tough call for Michigan, but those things happen.
Brown had no place to go, and he gets the roll. But Jamal Brown has certainly played a game today. As we told you, his career high was 13 points, and he had that Thursday, and he's got 12 right now. Griffin comes up with it. One thing about Randy Ayers, he said our team will play hard, and Chris Gent certainly epitomizes that. There's a reach in by Baker, but it's going to be off of Baker.
Well, it's a tough defensive effort right here at Buckeye State. And with Riley back in the game, Gary, he had a good first half. So he's really got to come through for Michigan this second half.
It's tied up with 41, 14:25 left in the game. Here's Caleb. Caleb, mid-air suspension. Good body control and a two-point lead now for the Wolverines.
If that was a dive, I'd have given him a nine, wouldn't you? Nine and a half, maybe.
Michigan team sometimes pretty hard to figure out, but they know they have a fight on here today. They played well. They've been bombed at home by Purdue, lost a 20-point lead to Indiana on the road, and then at times have played as well as you'd expect the defending NCAA champions to play.
Baker really likes to penetrate, and he got down the middle that time, but he made the bad pass.
Botch, baseline, tally, and Carter intimidated the shot. There could have been a foul. In, but no whistle.
Riley got his dribble in right there. That's
Baker out of control. Gent able to retrieve it. He hits the deck, and here comes a three-on-one. And then Jackson breaks it up. Riley out of control and a charge. Oh, you talk about out of control, both ends of the floor. Brown saying, oh, I don't know if that was worth all of that. He paid for that one.
A result of all-out effort, Jerry. And here's a look at it. And look, you'll see Tally just take the Riley, take that ball to the basket. He was looking back for the pass, and no way could he see the defense setting up. And he just runs over.
That's his third, so Riley with three. Mills is on the bench with four.
Michigan back man-to-man.
Coming to the ball game at the 13-minute mark. Showing a little bit of patience this time, Ohio State. Then Davis from outside. Tipped out to Ramil Robinson, who's back into the ball game. Two-point lead for the Wolverines.
It was a good move by Mark right there. He went up to get the rebound. It was congested. He just quick-passed it out.
Roy Vaught separating himself from the defender. He has 8 points. Four-point lead. Jackson having a tough time inside. They've got Tolbert picking him up now.
Ohio State's got to get Jackson into their offense.
Carter, and that's blocked. It's going to be a foul on Riley, and that is his fourth. Riley's committed his fourth. It's been an unpredictable year for this Michigan team, and we asked Steve Fisher about it.
Yes, exactly, and those are games that you have to learn from. You know, you lose a 20-point lead, and of course, I had a nice view from it sitting on the bench watching it, so I've learned to play smarter, and I think that everyone, you know, has to learn and, you know, take something positive from a negative ball game.
Terry Mills reacting to that. 4-point lead now for Michigan as Carter at the line. Carter this year shooting 64%. Lane violation, by the way. So he's going to get another free throw. A lane violation by Michigan. So, he takes advantage of it.
Really helps the shooter to get that second chance, Gary.
I don't think Steve agreed with that, but now a 45-42 game. Bill Robinson getting ready to come in for Ohio State. As Carter, with a reprieve, hits both. He comes out now. Robinson comes in.
Ohio State in their press.
2-point lead now for the Wolverines. All also in the ballgame now is Chris Sutter for Michigan, number 34. There's Sutter. Good ball movement by the Wolverines. Bot can't get it, pushing inside. Sutter able to get to the ball before Trigg Lee.
Offensive rebound by Michigan.
Got the two freshman guards in there again. Gone to the three-guard offense, which used extensively in the first half. Ramil Robinson, great leaping ability, just up above the defender.
Davis did a good job keeping position on him, but Robinson just rolls above him for that shot.
Robinson starting to heat up, now has 17. Trigg Lee. Now he can face the basket and shoot it as opposed to Carter. That's a better shot for Ohio State.
Well, you know what a good game Lee had against Louisville. If he comes through in this second half, could be important. Ohio State.
He has his first two of the afternoon, a two-point lead for Michigan. Vermeil shaking Jim Jackson, but that again was not very well thought out. That was forcing the shot once again. Jackson off to Davis. Trigg Lee kicks it back out.
See the difference in Jackson pacing up that shot that time, Gary? I think he really does a good job being patient.
Very poised, and he gets inside as an end result, and it's tied up. Into Trigg Lee. Double pump.
Great assist by Jackson.
The Buckeyes lead it. And Ramil Robinson calls timeout. And listen to this.
Continues to experience upsets, Gary. Back in Daytona Beach, Florida, my hometown, can you believe it? Derek Cope from Spanaway, Washington, has scored his first career victory ever driving a Chevrolet product. He was the first victory he's ever had. In fact, it's the first full-time ride he's had. Terry Labonte finished second. An unbelievable finish to the Great American Race. Let's go back to you.
All right, Jack, back to basketball. Two-point lead for Ohio State. 10 minutes to go in the game.
He was covered up by Trigg Lee, and Bill Robinson had no place to go. Tried to pivot his way out, got caught with the travel.
Ohio State on a 6-0 run with a two-point lead.
Ohio State giving good help defensively inside.
Trigg Lee tries to take it in to Jackson. Jackson. Beautiful pass to Lee, overshoots it. Robinson tips once, and coming out of there with it is going to be Black.
There's so many easy shots Ohio State misses. This game and the Louisville game, Gary.
Boy, Jackson, you got to be alert because he will distribute the ball.
He might be the assist leader of the world if they'd hit those inside shots.
Foul as Robinson makes his move in the paint. Bill Robinson committing the foul. Coming up next, basketball action continuing with regional action. Park the Shark will have him in Shark's tank. The UNFL running Rebels against Arizona. Or you get to see Chris Jackson for LSU take on Vanderbilt next year on ABC. Robinson with two free throws, and Robinson at the line now is 7 of 11.
He's taken that first one each time as a warm-up, but hit the second one. Let's see if he repeats this time.
Bill Robinson, by the way, committed his third foul just a moment ago, and Ramirez misses both, but Griffin looks like Karam. Bob misses, and Riley over the back, and Riley's committed the foul. That's his fifth.
The This is just what Steve Fisher did not want, was getting in foul trouble in that defensive post area. That one was on the offensive board, but with Eric Riley fouling out, forces him to come back with Mills with four already on him and 9-10 to go, Gary.
And another thought, this is where they need Sean Higgins. They need another big man. He's out with a stress fracture back in Ann Arbor with an inner ear disorder. So Riley's fouled out. Mills is in with four. They might take it in against Mills. And Davis, nice lean in, and Bott with a rebound. Roy Bott, maybe the most underrated player in America. Two-point lead for the Buckeyes. 8:46 left in the game. Mills wanted to look low, and Jackson stripped it from him. Jackson not scoring a lot, but he's doing the other things. Drake Lee passes up a shot, a little too far out of his range.
Ohio State getting back into their thin offense right here. With a double post up high to set a pick for Baker.
Baker gets it out to Davis. Davis almost lost his dribble.
We're missing the good defensive job that Griffin has done on Jackson. He is really covered.
And a running one-hander by Davis. It's going to count, but he's called for the charge. That was a tough shot. He made it count, but he's also called for the foul.
Now Davis has to float it over the defense. No question, a nice move, and the referee made the good call. You see, Gary releases the ball before the contact right here. There's the foul as he comes down into the defense. A good call by the official.
So at the other end, Romeo Robinson go to the line. Davis, who did not shoot well in the game Thursday night, has come back strong. Really has settled into that sixth-man role for Ohio State. And Romeo gets this free throw. 51-48, Ohio State.
Ohio State gave up an offensive rebound the last missed free throw. They did not block out well over there on Trigg Lee's side.
It's a two-point game. 8 minutes to go. 19 points for Romeo Robinson. You would think they might take the ball in and try to get Mills out of there, force him into his fifth foul.
This point drop zone right here by Michigan, with Griffith playing up on the point. Now he'll fall back in, play between the ball and the basket.
Davis from outside, followed by Jackson, and Robinson got it. No, they're going to wave it off. Offensive interference.
Well, Jackson's shot was coming out. There's no question about it. Robinson, a little anxious, goes up and gets the early tip while it was on the rim.
First chance we get, we'll take a look at it. Here is Mills. And Mills does not get the basket. We would have tied it. Let's go back.
Here's the shot. And Jackson there in great shape. No question the ball's on it. It may have gone in, Gary.
We're going to take a break. Ohio State by two.
Final score, Missouri 92, Oklahoma 90.
Palmer, Lee Trevino, and others teeing it up against Gary Player and a team of international stars. The third round coverage of the Chrysler Cup. And then also ABC's Wide World of Sports presents the most grueling one-day endurance event in the world, the Bud Light Ironman Triathlon World Championships.
A steal by Ohio State right there on the inbound pass. And they had seven steals in the first half, and they haven't let up this second half.
Two-point lead for Ohio State. Mills playing with four fouls. Riley is fouled out of the game. Ohio State has three players with three fouls. Brown came back into the game, as did Perry Carter during the break for Ohio State. 7 minutes to go.
Michigan still in the zone.
Here's Jackson, scored only 2 points in the second half, but he's done everything else very well. Skip pass against that did not work. And Talley with the steal, and here's Brown at the other end.
Michigan over-anxious to take advantage of that steal. And you can see that steal coming on Carter's cross-court pass.
A little patience, this young Ohio State team. 2 weeks ago today, they upset 10th-ranked Louisville. Now trying to be another giant-killing thing occurring as the 5th-ranked Wolverines trail by two. Here's Carter in trouble. Griffin on the floor. And eventually, Bott comes up with it.
Everyone but the
concessionaire had a hand on that ball.
6 minutes to go. Michigan on this trip down, trying to either tie it or take the lead. In the Mills with Robinson on him. Basket will count, and Robinson's committed the foul. And that is his fourth.
Mills, a very aggressive post-up right here. He had the thought of sealing Robinson with that arm, but he didn't need it. He has four fouls on him, Gary. He's got to be careful with that ball.
Well, coming out of the game now goes Bill Robinson with the four. At the line with 5 points thus far is Mills, and the rebound is cleared. 51-all. Jackson for three. Caleb, who's just come into the ballgame, off to Ramil Robinson, and stripped to the foul.
Ohio State's having a little trouble against that zone. They're not getting into a pattern and don't seem to be solving that point drop.
Jackson committing the foul is second. Well, that's to be expected because Ohio State has had trouble with any kind of a half-court game. The inexperience starts to creep in. That's the reason they like to up-tempo at every opportunity. And a zone even further can complicate a young team's demeanor. Robinson, who seemingly has been at the free throw line all day, he now has hit for the day, 10 of 15. He has 20 points.
Well, Jackson can hit against that zone if they just find the right spot for him offensively.
Michigan by two, 53-51.
Jackson calls play number two here. Let's see if they go into some kind of movement rotation.
Craig Lee now who's come in favor of Bill Robinson. Mills playing strong with those four fouls, almost picked up his fifth there. And there's a nice pass to Brown, and Brown does not get the shot to go. No foul.
A lot of contact, Gary.
.55 left in the game. Michigan by two. Baker going for the steal. Good ball movement. Caleb is wide open.
All started when the defense went after the pass to Robinson and missed it. Broke them down defensively.
Very big trip down the floor now for Ohio State, who finds themselves down by four. Jackson retrieved by Brown. He got it up and won't go. Craig Lee's got it. And a foul spotted inside. Mills says it's not on me, but is it? If it is, that's his fifth. That's his fifth. Mills is fouled out.
Well, here it is, and it's Mills, number 52, that gets the foul called. And it's right there as he took the swipe at the ball. You're going to get that called a lot, Gary, even when you don't make contact. If you slap at that ball and the referee thinks you made contact, he's going to call that one. But, I give Bill some credit. He stayed in the game even though he had the four fouls. He stayed aggressive and hustling, got a couple of baskets. Well, they're going to miss him being out.
Well, the significance now, Joe, is they've run out of big men. They've got Mills and Riley fouled out. Sean Higgins not available to them. Michigan with a 55-52 lead. 4:27 left here in St. John Arena. Mark, you look at the foul difficulty thus far. Riley and Mills, they fouled out. Robinson with four. Baker and Gent with three each. Between Mills and Riley, they produced 14 points and seven rebounds. As the change coming into the ballgame now is they're going to have Setter coming in after Mills fouled out, and Lee hits the second free throw and cuts it to two.
Gary, the story on the book on Setter is he's a poor free throw shooter. He's only hit 5 of 12 for the year, so that could be a factor down the stretch. He would be the man to foul if Ohio State has to foul.
Setter's had a lot of injury problems. You can see that heavily wrapped right elbow that kept him out of 2 years. Setting those picks. Robinson working off of it. Blocked nicely by Trigg Lee. A chance to tie. Gents back into the game. Chris Gents.
Michigan in the 1-2-2 zone.
They're in that zone earlier to try to protect Terry Mills, who fouled out anyway. Gents from the corner, three. Jackson tries to keep it, does, puts it up, got it, he's fouled.
Shot was going to be missed. 80% of them go away from the shot. That's where Jackson was.
Griffith committed his third foul. Jackson now gives the Buckeyes a one-point lead. Jackson now with 12 points. Has a score that much, but he's done everything that's possible to keep this Ohio State upset in the making. Robinson missing, and there is Trigg Lee with a powerful defensive rebound. Jackson to Jett. Jett will back it out.
Well, Jett doesn't want to miss unless Jackson's under that basket, Jerry.
That's not too dumb, is it?
No.
All right, these Sunday afternoon games here in St. John Arena getting awfully big here in Columbus.
Here's the rotation that gets the zone to send the shooter through to the corner.
Almost thrown away. Jackson retrieving with 12 seconds on the shot clock. He's taking over now.
Well, this may be a Jackson Robinson show from here on out there.
58-55, the Buckeyes. Caleb had to change the shot. And we're going to have a foul coming up on Chris Gent. That would be his fourth.
Gent was so anxious to get that ball that he ramped Caleb up from the backside to try to tie him up. There's just no way he could do it without fouling.
So Gent with his fourth. Gent, one of those guys, you almost wonder if he shouldn't be playing some football somewhere. What an aggressive, fierce competitor. He comes out, Randy Ayers talking it over. Baker comes into the game now for the Buckeyes. 2:13 left. Caleb at the line.
He's a 67% shooter from the line.
His first free throw of the day.
Look at Bob Mike Carter for the offensive rebound position right here. You know, he gets inside on almost every miss.
Well, Bob is their remaining big man after Mills and Riley fouled out. Griffin was in too short, couldn't come up with a rebound, and now they say it's a traveling call.
The crowd thought the contact caused Brown to walk right then, as it looked like Caleb went over his back going for the ball.
Ohio State by two. There's Griffith. He's over the end line, so the Buckeyes will get it anyway. Not a good pass at all that time. A little shaken that time. So Michigan turns it over. Center will come into the ball game for Michigan. They have six guys on the floor. Finally, Colbert comes off.
Good defensive pressure by Ohio State on that throw-in.
Timeout is called. 2:09 to go. Ohio State, the Spoilers, the Giant Killers, if you will, by two.
What a college outing this is, Gary. The tradition of the past with all the captains introduced, and now the enthusiasm of this young Ohio State team and its student body.
Buckeyes by two. Lee's got to be careful. He does go over and back. Has a lot of pressure. Jackson able to save it. Jackson seems to be everywhere.
You just wouldn't think that a freshman would be the key player in a situation like this, but all eyes are on Jim Jackson right now.
You see Randy Ayers at 33 years of age doing all the coaching he can do right now. He's got everything ready to go with 15 seconds on the shot clock.
Jackson cut through to that corner. That's who they're looking for. They may have to do it off of penetration.
5 seconds on the shot clock. Four from the corner. Jamal Brown. It's a three-pointer. zone, and this is what they got.
Well, that corner is what they've worked for, is to get that corner shot. And here's Fisher immediately trying to call the timeout, and he couldn't get any of his players pay him any attention.
He got it, and Michigan has one timeout left. 61-56 Ohio State.
Michigan needs a basket here and another possession, even with a three-pointer.
Robinson from 3 points. He got it. Who else? He's been their big man for so many years. Two-point game.
They immediately look around and see where Jackson is.
Brown gets it off to Mark Baker. Baker's got to get out of that corner where they can trap him.
Michigan out into man-to-man, really putting the pressure on.
And there's a foul. Caleb fouling Baker. Now, Baker's a 62% free throw shooter. Randy Ayers, you can see the crossed arms. He wanted an intentional foul, but that will not happen as Baker now with the pressure coming at the free throw line.
Well, not a bad move by Michigan to get that foul. And you have to be very careful. Even if you tell your players to foul, you've got to warn them to make them go after the ball and not make it intentional.
Mark, the foul there was
pretty far away from the ball.
This is his first free throw of the afternoon. And it's rebounded by Ramil Robinson. The Wolverines down by two, and you see the time remaining.
The shot clock is off. Here's Robinson.
He was going to shoot it. Passes instead. The layup by Bott is good, and he's fouled. Lloyd Bott reaching in, scoring, and he's fouled.
Well, Robinson just made a great play. Robinson felt the shot, went up, and the defense cut him off, but he sees Bott in under the basket wide open and kicked it off. A great, great assist by Robinson.
The foul going on Jackson, his third. Bott with his first free throw to try to break the tie.
Unusual touch for a big man at the free throw line, 83%.
And he missed it. Ohio State 61, Michigan 61.
Randy Ayers calling for a timeout. Will steady his play with 19 seconds to go.
All even. 19 ticks left. We'll be back in just a moment. 61 all, 19 seconds left in the game. Ohio State asking for the timeout. They have the ball at midcourt.
Well, right now you can bet that Michigan is looking that chart over to see who the man is to foul. And Baker's already missed one, so that could be what they're looking for.
Jackson will inbounds their best passer.
Trick Lee shooting 55%. Ohio State won't want the ball in his hands in this possession. There was the reach in.
Foul on Baker, the guy who missed the front end of a 1-1 earlier. Caleb committing the foul.
Michigan checking their timeouts. Steve Fisher holding up a sign that says low.
Both teams with one timeout remaining. Baker 0 for 1 today.
If he makes this one, it's simply a no-foul situation for Ohio State. If he does make it, there's always that question of whether you should foul, make them shoot the free throws instead of getting the three-point opportunity. And they'll certainly be looking for Robinson if he misses this one.
He gets the final pick, Jim Jackson.
Can you believe that? Jim Jackson does it again.
Michigan calls their last timeout with 8 seconds. Jim Jackson is a money man. Ago had the follow shot against Louisville that upset 10th-ranked Louisville, and watch this one.
Well, there's where they missed Mills in not getting the block out right there on Jackson as he got inside for that tip.
Randy Ayers,
Randy.
He says, no timeout now.
Not now.
10 freshman of the year, Jim Jackson, on two Sunday afternoons has certainly made a push for that. Maybe the best freshman in the country.
Randy Harris sending Gent back into the game for defense right now. As he's got an all-big team in here with Brown, 6'4 guard, and obviously moving Jackson to a guard.
So the three-point shot is what Michigan's going to look for. And they are 3 of 7 thus far from three-point land.
Four guards in for Michigan right now as they're looking for quickness and outside shooting.
Their best three-pointer, Sean Higgins, obviously not playing today. And Jamal Brown almost came up with a steal. It'll be Michigan's ball. 6 seconds, took two off the clock.
A three-point lead right here, 64-61.
Earlier, Joe, the scoreboard clock was wrong here. They had 65-61.
Well, that's what confused me, Gary, because we were thinking it was out of touch for Ohio State.
Now they're going to put a second back on the clock to 7, but it is a three-point game, 64-61. Tony Tolbert will inbound. Jim Burr, the official, hands him the ball.
A lot of coaches think you should foul.
Three-pointer
right
by Robinson for the game. Bart, with 3 seconds, puts it up. It's over.